If you'd like to see how I'm going to transform this plain bottle of Coca-Cola into this lovely, glamorous rhinestone and glitter embellished bottle, keep watching this video. Hey YouTube. So today in this video, I'm going to be adding some glitter to this glass bottle of Coca-Cola. And as you can see, I will be using some red glitter, and I have my Mod Podge. I'm going to apply the glitter with the Mod Podge, and I'm going to be using a different method of sealing the glitter. I have some Deco Art clear pouring top coat. So I'm very interested to see how this is going to go with my glitter. I wanna make sure everything is nice and sparkly. That was an issue with glitter that I've been having. So we're gonna see how this turns out. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. I already poured a little bit of the Mod Podge on this top here. So you will need some type of sponge brush. You can purchase these at Dollar Tree or your local craft store. And I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. I've already wiped this bottle off completely with some alcohol just in case. Then I have like a little paper here that I will go ahead and shake everything onto. So let's get started. Just go ahead and watch me carefully apply the glue to the bottle. Want to make sure you use nice and smooth strokes. If you want to, you can mask off. I don't like to mask, so I just try to keep my hands steady. So go ahead and just keep watching.
You just want to take your sponge brush and make sure that you lay your glitter nice and flat and nice and even. You want a nice even spread of your glue so your glitter lays nice and flat. And you just gently just dust your glitter on just like so. Usually I would have saw myself painting the bottle, but for some reason I just didn't see the need to. And if you're wondering what the point of this bottle is, it's actually just a great keepsake. And I wanted to do some testing on my glitters just so I could see how to keep it nice and shiny. I didn't see a reason to keep the back labeling on, so I just went ahead and covered that up, as you can see. I'd rather look at glitter than nutritional facts and a barcode.
If you have an extra or old makeup brush, it really comes in handy just to dust off any excess glitter that you don't need. So you can kind of just dust it out the way and see what you're doing.
Okay, so the two layers has dried. Two layers of glitter that I applied with Mod Podge. I poured some of this Deco Art clear pouring top coat into this little lid. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and cover this up, let that dry, then we'll see how this seals the glitter. It looks like it's white, and it should dry clear. So we're just gonna go ahead and get. So in this portion of the video, I was actually outside in the backyard trying to kick it with my family and still finish my video, but it was almost dark, so the lighting isn't the best, but I did add rhinestones to this top area.
See, I did add some rhinestones. I was outside earlier, the lighting probably wasn't the best, but I decided to add some rhinestones on this area of the bottle. Now I'm just gonna, I was gonna leave it and just have this be it. But I feel like it's a little naked. I feel like it's missing something. So I had bought some of these little SS4, I think these are. They're so tiny. So hopefully they at least show up. But I just wanted to put something on this little.
I definitely feel like my outline could have been a lot better. Working with these itty bitty rhinestones was kind of a little on the challenging side. And plus, due to me already having all this glitter in the way. So my line is not perfect, as you can see, but I still feel like it needed something there, so. Okay, you guys, here is the final finished result of this glitter Coca-Cola bottle. And I think this is really, really cute. It's different. It's something nice that you can sit on your mantelpiece, like a little conversation piece, especially if you're really, really into Coca-Cola. And I have done some Coca-Cola and Pepsi pop cans. Check those videos out as well. So this is for the Coca-Cola lovers. I think that the Deco Art medium pouring solution, in which I sealed the glitter with, is not bad. I think it is a little bit shinier than it would be if I used Mod Podge, in my opinion. So I think I would use this again. In another video, I did a wine glass and I sealed the glitter. I did a wine bottle and I sealed the glitter with a liquid medium pouring called Tri-Art Liquid Glass. For some reason, I still like that one better. Probably because I sealed it with confetti glitter. So I'll have to just keep testing this out to find something to really hold that glittery, sparkly shine. But I like this. I think it's really cute. You guys, let me know what you think. Are you digging this? Do you think that this was a great way to seal the glitter? I purchased that medium pouring, which is usually used on acrylic painting, or people use it to mix it with paints. And when they pour it on their canvases, I believe, it just helps it stay shiny or something like that. So that's why I've been trying these different things out. And it was $10 from Hobby Lobby. Thanks you guys for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy it. Share this video on Facebook if you can. Subscribe to this channel if you'd like to see more videos like this. If not, thanks for stopping by. Bye-bye.